Hey everybody, it's Darcy the Bad Artist from London, Ontario. Hope you're having a great day. I can't talk long. I've got great news. We've reached 100 subscribers today. I don't think it's a record, but we're pretty close. I've actually read on online that if you get 100 subscribers, YouTube is going to show up with pizza and cake for me. I don't want them to know that I know they're coming, but I am trying to dress up. I've got to pick between two ties, this conservative one here, the blues and the blacks, or here it is, or this one here, which is my wine tie, which is nice little bottles of wine on it, kind of, you know, to celebrate the accomplishments we've made. So anyway, I gotta go, I gotta look surprised, get my surprise face, oh my god, get my surprise face on, but listen, this video is about a piranha, a fast attack redback piranha. So anyway, thanks again for the support. This has been really fun, and well, that might be them. Gotta go. Hey everybody, we're just talking about the piranha here. So you may not have figured this out, but I'm kind of a big nerd. Part of me doing this piranha is I'm trying to put together a Dungeons and Dragons module sometime this year, and one of the first encounters is going to be piranha that attack the adventurers. But anyway, that's why I did this. But a lot of interesting facts on these piranha. A couple things. While they are fierce, they're not as fierce as one may think. They have some are vegetarians, and for the most part, they just sort of attack weak or dying or almost dead creatures. The apparently the target they have, they usually, this is kind of gross, they either go after the victim's eyes or their tail in the case of a fish first to immobilize them, then they just sort of go nom 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 and eat the rest of them, and they make that sound too, nom 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 nom. But apparently what originally didn't help, Theodore Roosevelt, who was the 26th President of the United States, actually visited them in South America, which is where they're from, and he described them to journalists as ferocious eating beasts that would kill and maim animals much larger than their own size that attacked in packs, and as a result of that, it just sort of kept going on and on from there. They've made a couple movies, one in 1977, where of course typical beachgoers or teenagers got eaten, and then a 3D movie, which came out later as well. Speaking of South America, so they are from South America, but this is kind of neat. I thought, if there are ever any piranha found outside of South America, and they've given examples like Texas and China and even Great Britain, they're basically old pets. They just do not live outside of South America. In the rare occasion that they have found them, they said, you know what, this, the only way this can be possible is if it's somebody's pet. So that was kind of neat. They tend to be actually pretty docile, and they only would attack if you attack them or threaten them. And they've also, if they're ever caught, there's three different sounds they make. And scientists sort of think, you know, could be any sort of meaning. Basically, one would be, hey, back off, I'll bite you. The other one is, you know what, help me. And they'll communicate that to other fish, probably piranha in the pack. And then the third one is just kind of a, oh no, what did I do? I'm up the creek now. But other than that, this is really a neat, neat fish to do. We're going to get into an octopus next. And again, I don't know if you caught the beginning of this video. Really, really want to thank everyone for, I can't believe I got 100 subscribers. I can't listen to myself, let alone finding 100 people that would want to listen to me at the same time. But we're moving along. Got some other ideas. Got some people that are making suggestions for painting fish. And people are starting to like this dumb trivia, which is kind of what all I know. I'm not the smartest clown out there. But, oh, hey, another thing about the piranha. They lose their teeth in groups of four. Now, how's that for stupid trivia? You'll be on Jeopardy, and Alex Trebek will say, you know, the number of teeth piranha lose, and you're going to go, Alex, What is four? Because they lose them in groups of four that are connected together rather than a single tooth at a time. And they do grow back, much like everything else. There's the final painting. And there it is there. And again, I photoshopped the background, but those three piranha in there are the image that were reduced down and put into the background. Again, can't thank you enough. Thank you for the 100 subscribers. I want to set a goal of 150 by August 2018. It's pretty aggressive. Please subscribe and like if you can. And there's also another link to a video, which is the lightning clownfish. Have a great day.